Hey, I'm Megan and I'm back with some more Dollar Tree DIYs for Easter, and these will be a little bit more neutral than my last DIYs. For my first DIY, I'm using this wreath form from the Dollar Tree. It's the biggest one they carry. And I'm also using some Kroger ads to wrap it all the way around my wreath. I used a little duct tape in the beginning, but as I continued to wrap, I didn't continue to tape. I only taped the beginning and the end. So when I'm done, it looks about like this. I did want it even more girthy and thick, so I added some craft paper this time and wrapped it around the wreath the same way. Once again, a piece of duct tape when I first started wrapping, and then I didn't use tape again until the end, but you can already see like how much more thick this wreath is becoming. And when I finished, I did put duct tape all over the back just in case. Obviously, this will be an indoor wreath only. Two bags of Dollar Tree moss, and I cut it up really, really well because that helps out when I add the moss to my wreath with hot glue. And I did this all over the wreath, on the front, the sides, everywhere minus the back. It kind of reminded me of like a moss glazed donut at one point in time. But anyways, here's what it looks like when it's done. Then I'm taking these flowers from the Dollar Tree and I'm going to cut them in half using hot glue. I'm gonna add them all the way around my wreath, and I do have them pointing in the same direction, but I tried to add them as sporadically as possible. Then I'm just taking some twine, also from the Dollar Tree, and wrapping it all the way around my wreath, back and forth, crossing, no rhyme or reason, once again. Two carrots from the Dollar Tree, tied twine around them, and I just use burlap to tie a little bow, and I'm going to tie my carrots to the burlap bow, and then here's my wreath. I really like this. I've made a moss wreath like this before, but I wanted one even bigger. I'm glad that my idea of using the paper worked out well. And I'm also glad I did use the craft paper because I didn't want like buy a stake, get a stake free showing through on my wreath. In my last video, I used two of these signs to create this big bunny on the left. And I removed the glitter bunny that comes on the sign with pliers. I had one of those bunnies left over and I'm using that bunny today along with some brown wood look craft paper from Dollar Tree. Cover my bunny and then I cut it out, but I'm not too concerned if I get it perfectly because I actually like to use sandpaper to get more of a perfect cut when removing contact paper. It works well for me and it gets it a lot more clean looking than if I were to use scissors and try to cut out the little nooks and crannies of the bunny. Now you may have noticed I didn't cover the bunny's hands all the way. That was an accident, no big deal. I just took another little piece of contact paper and covered it up and it blends in just fine. You can also see that the bunny came out pretty clean using the sandpaper. Now I'm taking black acrylic paint and I'm painting all over the bunny and then I wipe it away immediately while it's still wet. I like trying to make fake wood look like real wood the best I can. My only regret is I wish I would have removed the glue before I added the contact paper because you can really see like it looks like a tumor the bunny has. But you live and you learn, I know for next time. Black acrylic paint on the side of the bunny. And then I'm using one of these signs from the Dollar Tree. The one I'm using I actually already did a DIY on for Valentine's Day, but that doesn't matter because I'm using the back of the sign. I love multi-purpose decorations. And I'm pulling the part of the sign, like the sides off, because I don't want the little triangles in my sign. And I just pull them off the pliers. They come off really, really easy. I did save the little rectangular part for later on in this DIY. Now, while I have the sign open, I'm gonna go ahead and paint it all over with chalk paint. One coat, didn't worry about full coverage, didn't bother me one bit. And then black acrylic paint on the sides of the frame all over, and then I just used a dab of hot glue to put the frame back together. Now I decided after I did this that I wanted this to look more like shiplap or wood. I wish I would have done this when I still had the frame like busted wide open, but I didn't. Oh well. So I'm just taking a pencil, color pencil, and I'm freehanding back and forth to try to make this look more like shiplap. Like I said, I should have did this before I closed the frame, using the rectangle I put on the back of my bunny with hot glue to the inside of my frame, and now it's kind of like a little shadow box. I really like the way this would have looked if I would have removed the glue. I did add the little bow back. I'm still happy I did this DIY because it gave me some inspiration of how to make fake wood look more realistic for next time. My last DIY, I'm using this little frame from the Dollar Tree, and the circle removes really easy. You just pulled it right off. And I'm using the lighter wood contact paper, also from the Dollar Tree. And once again, I'm just going to sand off the edges because it just gets a really clean cut. I'm telling you, it works best for me anyways. Brown acrylic paint, and I'm painting all over the frame first. And once that dried, I went back with some white chalk paint. I started off with a really small brush because I thought it'd be easier, but then I switched to a wider flathead brush, and this was actually a lot easier to get really close to the edge of the frame without getting on the brown paint. Hot glue, and I'm going to add my little wood circle back to the middle of the frame. And then the other two carrots from the Dollar Tree, I just kind of hot glue them how I like them. And I decided I wanted to add a little bitty twine bow, so I go back and add my little twine bow. And here it is. I think this is really cute, and I actually think this will be cute throughout the summer for like kitchen decor, and I'm actually gonna put it in my kitchen tray. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time.